This is the Smart Ramps board. It's able to hold 5 native stepper drivers, being E0, E1, those are extruders, so extruder 1, extruder 2. Then we have X, Y, and Z. We have pins over here to connect to the NEMA motors, so NEMA 17 is usually standard. So the only interesting exception here would be your Z, which has 2 sets of pins for either side of your steppers, being 2 motors. I want to talk about how this is inserted. I'll cover this in greater detail in a moment, but for now, what I want to talk about is the microstep pin jumpers. On the smart ramps, they no longer exist. They're hardwired to either do 1/16th of a step or 1/32nd of a step. So in a moment, I'll show you the A4988 and how it works. And you could probably figure out from my example how the DRV8825 will work from that. If not, ask. Here's the top side of the A4988. What I want to point out is the pin location for the enable pin, which is right here. And in a moment, I'll show you what it looks like on the underside. This is the underside of the A4988. I want to show you the enable pin once more. This will have to be matched on the smart ramps board for any one of the driver ports that you connect it to for the female side. That way you'll prevent it from actually being destroyed. Okay, I want to talk about the port for the X. At the very bottom of the port, right here, there is an EN. That is the pin right here where I'm hovering over that you try and match up for your stepper drivers that I showed previously in the video. If you don't match up that pin, you will have issues such as cooking your board. Okay, in order to place this correctly in your X female ports for the X stepper driver, you have to line up your EN pin with the EN pin over here, and then apply a little bit of thumb pressure, and that's how you install the stepper driver. Now this will be the same for each and every one of these configurations where you have to install a stepper driver. Some of them are written quite well on the silk screen to the board. That would be the lettering. Others are not, so you might have to use a key of figuring out the patterns that match. Or you can just work from this end, add your next one over here, and your next one over here. In a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware on the board for the stepper driver. Okay, the first thing we want to do is open up Adreno.exe. Then we want to go to the configuration.h tab. We want to search on motherboard. We want to verify that it's board_ramps_smart_EFB. So we have the correct board. Next thing we want to do is search on default_axis. And here's where the meat of the matter is. For X, Y, Z, E0, and E1, we have our defined options below. Notice that the first value is 80, which is for X, that's for steps. Then we have 80 for Y, 4000 for Z,
and 500 for the E0. So in this case, all we want to do is compile and upload. So let's verify that we have the correct board, which is Arduino Duo programming port. And it's on COM port 3, which is selected. So we're going to compile and upload.
Okay, to prep it, to test it, we have to connect the four pins for the NEMA 17 stepper. We then have to connect the power from the power supply. And then we have to plug it in. Now keep in mind, we're going to use the end stop to watch for the end of the access. In a moment, I'll show you in Pronterface how we actually test it.
Okay, the first thing we want to do is open up Pronterface. We then want to connect to the motherboard. Now what we want to do is press the home button and then click the end stop with our fingers. But before we do that, let's verify the end stop is actually open, which it is. So now we're going to click home for the x-axis and then with our finger press the end stop. Okay. In a moment, what I'm going to do is I'm going to advance the x-axis by 10 to verify that it's working. So, as you can see, okay, so I'm going to advance by 10. And then I'm going to advance by 100 so you can see it better.
So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.